Hello everyone, today our day 4 of practical class, and today we will be doing this practical that we started previous day, that is potassium permanganate and oxalic acid, which is acid catalyzed. This is the process as it was shown previous day. This is the procedure. I hope you all have already written this one in the file. So experiment number 2, part 2, that is today we will be doing calculation of the X. Oxalic acid, which is hydrated, that is COOH.XH2O. You need to calculate the value of X as you did it for more salt case. Similarly, today your target, your question is C10 prepared by permanganate solution 3.1 gram per liter as we took last day. But today here, instead of dissolving this impure sample, you will be considering 6.5 gram of pure sample of oxalic acid. And then your target will be to calculate molality for both C10 and C11 solution, and also gram per liter for C11 solution, and the value of X, that is COOH-COOH-XH2. I hope you all can write the calculation, because I gave how to solve X calculation in case of more salt K1O4 practical. So in the similar way, you will be solving X calculation for this. So for that, you need to have first calculation, because molecular weight initially you cannot calculate as it is XH2O. So you need to find out the strength from the Burette reading. Now you can consider the Burette reading that has come during the practical, or you can use these data as well. This 20.2, 20, 20. These data also you can use, or previous data, anything you can use. If you are using these data, then calculations will be accordingly. And you complete the two titration. We have these two titration in our syllabus. So there will be four practicals. Each titrations, two practicals. So four practicals must be written in your practical file so far. So let's continue with the practical.
We have C10 solution of supplied strength. We have C11 oxalic acid. It's K1O4. We have dilute sulfuric acid. Already the burette is filled up with C10 solution. This titration is based on KMnO4 and oxalic acid redox reaction, acid catalyzed.
So today our titration is based on the redox reaction among potassium permanganate and oxalic acid. It's also permanganometry, and here potassium permanganate is a self indicator. So we are not taking any indicator from outside. Similar like previous day, the burette is filled up with potassium permanganate solution, that is C10 solution, and pipetting out of C11 solution is going on. We will take oxalic acid in a clean conical.
To check the mark, which is 20 ml, now we transfer it in conical.
The reaction is acid catalyzed, so we are taking one test tube of dilute sulfuric acid and adding it to the oxalic acid solution.
Now we need to heat the solution to approximately 60 to 70 degrees centigrade.
We will be continuing warming the solution till it is unbearable to touch.
Make sure the solution should not boil. When it is almost unbearable to touch, at that point of time, we should start the titration rapidly with the solution.
We need to do the titration process very rapidly so that the temperature remains at the range of 60 to 70 degrees centigrade. If the temperature falls during the titration, then there may be a possibility to have a wrong reading.
You need to titrate with constant shaking. As you can see, the color is coming and disappearing. When the color will persist, that will be your end point.
So that's the end point.
This is the end point. The color is persistent. This is the end point. 19.5.
Now you can use 19.5 as the Burette reading for the calculations.
Or you can use the reading that already I have shown at the beginning of this class. And about writing also we have discussed.
And complete your file as soon as possible. Bye.